Y'all, so I'm about to end this vlog. Y'all see Jazz over there in the corner, Jada over here cleaning kitchens. Y'all see what time it is, right? Ow! Y'all see it is 12:11. We watching Raven Elise old vlogs and meal prep for at least 3 days is done, and y'all, this has been a freaking task, hasn't it? Let me get out the way, because Jada looked like she about to go off on me, because she got to clean up the damn kitchen, you know what I'm saying? So, your girl is about to shut it down, because I am, when I tell y'all, I'm beyond sleepy. I didn't even finish preparing everything that I wanted to prepare because I'm tired and I don't want to half-ass on my food. So I had some other things I wanted to share with y'all. However, y'all are gonna have to wait because y'all know, hey! Damn. I had some other things I wanted to chit-chat with y'all, but y'all know I could get a little long-winded, so guess what? Y'all just gonna have to stay tuned for the next vlog, and maybe the next vlog, instead of just telling y'all, I'll show you, okay? So, good night, and I hope you guys had a wonderful weekend. Today is Palm Sunday, and Stephanie is gonna get herself in the bed, okay? So, good night, Eclectnistas. Y'all be sure to subscribe, and I'll see y'all same time, same place tomorrow. Be weary of the ways of the world. Be weary of the ways of the world. Be weary of the ways of the world. Hey y'all, it is 1:00 in the afternoon and I'm headed to work. Y'all know. I'm gonna keep it real with y'all. This morning I woke up and I was slightly aggravated. However, I had to snatch my own life back real quick because remember I told y'all I gotta make it about me now. I can love my children. I can want the best for them. I can advise them. I can inspire them. And I'm gonna tell y'all what like just irks my whole spirit after I tell y'all what happened. So Mr. Long gets up last night, somewhere around my 2, maybe 3-ish, and he goes downstairs to turn the TV off because we know Jada is up. It's spring break. He goes down there and he sees that she's sleeping and, you know, she's in our chairs, sitting down, well, laying down in a chair and stuff. And he finds something that he ain't supposed to find. What y'all think he found? Just guess. A phone, y'all. He found a damn phone. So, phone lit up, okay? Because she done fell asleep on the phone. Or she done fell asleep and didn't put the phone away. So, y'all probably like we were, Steph, where'd Jada get a phone? That's the $1 million question, right? Because we ain't purchased her no phone. So, Jada has come in contact with somebody else's phone yet again. So, Mr. Long, he just picked up the phone, turned the TV off. He came upstairs. He asked me, he was like, "Do you know about this?" "Nah, player. I'm in shock too. You just woke me up with some news, okay?" And so I was like, "She bold and she came up here and got one of our phones." And he was like, "No, your phone is sitting right here on the nightstand, charging." I said, "Well, yours?" He was like, "Both of his phones is over there where they supposed to be. We know she don't got Jasmine's phone, y'all. Jasmine fall asleep with her damn phone in her hand, okay? So we don't know where she got the phone." Hold on, y'all. Hold that thought. Okay, so y'all, Mr. Long, we are like trying to figure out where she got this phone. And he was like, "Steph, I want you to go back to sleep. No need to get upset. We ain't gonna fuss about this." He said, "I just took it." So y'all would think like first thing this morning, like, you know, she'd come upstairs, say hello. No, when you're guilty, you kind of want to stay away from the people you know you're guilty with, okay? So I go downstairs and y'all just ask a simple question because I was getting ready and, you know, had phone calls to make and all that stuff this morning. So I asked her, I said, "So where did you get that phone?" And she said she got it from one of her friends at school. And I was like, "Why?" She was like, "Because I knew I wasn't going to have anything to do for spring break." So, of course, y'all know I had to ask Jada, like, how the heck you know what you was going to have planned? I mean, what? Being on the phone, that's something to do. Like, you got TV, you got games you can play, you got things that you can draw. You have things that you can do when we are not home, okay? But you have a house phone, okay, that you can be on. But you rather risk or take a risk and get in trouble and get somebody else's phone and get on the phone. Okay. So, y'all, I did not fuss. I did not fuss. Why? I ain't fuss. And honestly, I could just tell y'all, I went upstairs, I had a little moment, and I asked God, "If I gave it to you, I gotta leave it exactly where I left it." Just as a mother, I don't want anything to happen to her to where she messes up and like regrets, like, "Damn, if I would have just listened." I've told y'all that before and I'm telling y'all that again. Yet y'all probably like, "Steph, it's just a phone. It's a phone that we did not authorize her ass to have. How about that?" Because when you can't do right in school, you can't, your grades aren't up to par, and, you know, we gotta fuss and fight with you about, you know, your chores and stuff like this. But then you wonder, like, why you don't get to do things like a regular teenager. It's because you haven't earned those things. And, oh my God, I feel myself getting angry with y'all. Because I'm trying not to show her that I'm angry with her anymore. And I'm going to tell you why. Y'all, when we went to the family therapist last summer, and the family therapist made something crystal clear to me that apparently the past couple of weeks or past couple of months, I just have not been adhering to, but I need to get back to the basics. And the basics is that you can't let these children know they've won, okay? So you getting upset, getting all in an uproar, you know, fussing, yelling, you know, to me it's like a scream for attention, but like that's a scream for the wrong type of attention. It irks my soul when I have so many of y'all write me emails, send me DMs, send me snaps, send me messages all the time that say, you know, "You inspire me, you know, you make me want to be better, you make me want to do better." As a young girl, as a teenager, you're giving me helpful advice on what not to do when I get in high school or while I'm in high school. Or you know, you're helping me. But I can't even inspire someone that lives in my house to just want to do the right thing. And y'all, it just makes me really question, like, what be going on in Jada's mind? Like, for real. Something that I've never shared with y'all before, but I'm gonna share it with you now, because it's something that clearly, you know, we have like kind of like, I guess, put on a back burner because I don't believe in this because I'm old school. However, I'm just starting to just wonder, you know, if I need to take a different approach to this. Jada can't focus on nothing, okay? She can't focus. And her focus is very minimal. If, you know, she was talking to the doctor last week and she was telling the doctor that, you know, when she's in class, like after sitting down for 10-15 minutes, like she has to get up, she has to walk around, she has to talk, she has to do something, but she can't sit there still enough, she can't sit still long enough to be able to pay attention in class, okay? So back in Atlanta, when we lived in Atlanta, Jada was diagnosed with ADHD. y'all, we followed all the protocol with the ADHD, you know, screening process, all of that good stuff. Jada actually was put on meds. And I'm going to tell y'all, we did not like the way Jada was when she was on meds. She like turned into a freaking zombie, okay? And like, we did this for like the second half of the school year, and granted it did help her as far as like stay a bit more focused in class. It did help like tone down like all the, you know, wanting to talk all the damn time, you know, it toned all of that down. However, we just didn't like that when she came home, she was just a totally, like, she just was, like, in a zone. And then, like, I guess because the medicine was time released, it would be, like, maybe around 6, 7 o'clock, she would kind of return back to, like, herself. But then we had to do this process all over again in the morning. Well, we went through the summer like this because she went to her grandparents, and my father-in-law, he was giving her the meds and stuff like that. And he was just like, Steph, she just different. And I was like, okay, it's not just me and James and Jasmine, it's grandparents noticing it too. So y'all, when we moved to Valdosta, we decided to take her off and let her see how she could cope with just, I'm sorry, like I said, I'm old school. You know, back in the day when I was growing up, there was no magic pill that made your ass right. It was called your ass got your ass whipped, and you know, you gon' fix this shit or you gon' get your shit together. You got make roast, okay? You didn't take, you know, whatever it is, Prozac or Adderall or what they got these kids on now. Like, you didn't take shit like that. You got your ass whipped and you made a choice. I'm gonna get my shit together or I'm gonna have to face the May Rose. Simple. Now, all these doctors, and to me, all these teachers want to do nowadays is just put children on meds and make them fucking zombies. Sorry, y'all, if I'm cussing, but I'm just really trying to, like, figure out what's going on with my child. And so, when we had the parent-teacher conference, this was one thing that one of the teachers or the counselors, she's familiar because this has followed Jada from elementary school, middle school, now high school. She mentioned it and she was like, do you think it's something that you guys may need to revisit? You know what? I do. And guess what? I made an appointment for her last week, and that's the doctor's appointment that she had. And this week we got a referral in the mail for her to go speak to a child psychologist so that we can see if this is probably part of the problem, why she can't focus, why she can't sit down and stay still in class long enough to get the lesson that the teacher is trying to teach, because she too focused on other things such as girl drama. Like that, like that's her ish. Like, if there was a class in high school called girl drama, Jada would be getting flying colors in that class right now, right? Okay, she have A's. I am not embarrassed. I am not feeling some kind of way about this. You want to know why? Because I want to give my child the best opportunity that she can possibly have to have a successful future. Okay, because right now the road she going on with not being able to stay focused and stuff, I don't know what that future look like, y'all. So as a mother, I'm going to help with God first. And then my husband as my partner, we about to figure this shit out. And that's on some real. So right now, I told her the goal of the day is to stay out of trouble. Phone got taken away. She has a house phone at the house. And I was like, you know what? This is how you always... I'm a girl proudly rocking a fade. You feel me? Home at last. In my own domain, okay? Because this is the Historia. However, I'm about to be a good little vlogger and I'm about to edit this video so y'all will get this first thing either tonight or in the morning. All right, y'all, it is midnight and it is, what's today? Tuesday morning? Early Tuesday morning, right here, vlog number one for spring. Life with Steph is going up, and I'm sitting in here, Jazz on the floor. You know, that's her favorite spot. I was supposed to finish my meal prepping from the other night. You said what? Well, put it in the dishwasher. I ain't about to have him nothing. It ain't my kitchen night. It ain't my kitchen night.
It's never your kitchen night.
You're damn right. You're damn right. You're damn right. That will stink, right? He comes for them. Oh, God. I was like glowing. I'm gonna get somebody scolded.
Yeah, look at these dishes in here.
Look, I ain't have to get up and make you that pasta salad.
I know you did it all the same, and you about to have me daddy fussing at us. Or me.
Well, y'all, I know earlier when I was talking to y'all in the car, I was so abruptly interrupted because my memory card said, stop, you ain't got no more space. So I had to just thug it out, and I didn't have an extra memory card. My other memory card is in my other camera. I think I need to start carrying like a backup 16 gig with me in case ish like this happened, because I know I was on a roll. However, y'all, I got Jada a doctor's appointment for tomorrow at 1:30, and I just want her to get herself together. That is the ultimate goal, plan, you name it. That's what it is. So, I'm about to close out for tonight, but I'll see y'all tomorrow, and we're going to continue this vlog on until Tuesday. And when I got off work today, y'all, I wasn't able to go to the gym because I was held up a bit when I was supposed to get off work. And then Mr. Long called me. I needed to stop and pick up some dish detergent for the dishwasher and the hand washables, you know. And then I picked up me some new vitamins because I needed something with a little extra vitamin D in it. And y'all got the most uneven freaking tan today when I was sitting outside eating my breakfast.
How can I go outside trying to get me some natural vitamin D and come out with a jacked up tan? Like, how do I fix this?
Trying to get my natural vitamin D. So we will see each other in the a.m. It is midnight. I am about to come up by this Girls Rockin' Fades tee and these camo overalls, and I am about to get ready to go to sleep. I need to put those shoes up before I go to bed too, y'all, because the pile will start to grow and multiply across the floor if I don't. So let me do myself a favor and handle that. So
I'll see y'all tomorrow. Good morning, y'all. It's Tuesday. Timer. 8:01, and I'm about to, I'm in the process of getting dressed for work, and I need to go run upstairs and grab me a black bra, because clearly my bra is purple, and with these black straps, and this open back, black on black, gonna work best. So, let me run upstairs and get my black bra, and I'll be back. All right, y'all. Your girl made it to work. I just scarfed down my breakfast because I didn't have time at the house. I didn't have time at the house to eat it. So, I just scarfed it down because we just got shipment. So, while I was back here receiving the shipment, I ate my breakfast. Now, I'm about to get back out on the floor because I'm only here until 12:30 today because Jada has a doctor's appointment that we will not be missing. So, I'll see y'all in a couple of hours when I get off. And when I say a couple, literally two. Okay. All right, y'all. We have went to Jada's doctor's appointment. And now we are here on McGuire Air Force Base to get this prescription filled. Because why pay to fill it at the local pharmacist when you can just come on base and get it filled? You feel me? You feel very bougie.
Yeah, I'm not even gonna put in the car keys. I feel very
bougie. Whatever. Oh, gosh. Good morning, y'all. It's Wednesday, and I'm sorry I didn't come back yesterday. I'm eating breakfast, oatmeal, and hard-boiled eggs. Y'all, I have not found a product yet to not make me look like I woke up with residue under my eyes. But the reason I didn't come back yesterday was because, y'all, I felt like I was driving all over the state of New Jersey yesterday looking for a prescription because no pharmacist had it. So finally, the base didn't have it. The first pharmacy I went to buy the base didn't have it. Dude was like, well, you wanna go to Trenton? Hell nah. We have one 10 miles up the road. Now, y'all, 10 miles up the road here in Jersey, it's far. That's all I'm gonna say. But by the grace of God, I found Jada's prescription. Thank God for insurance. I'm gonna tell y'all that because the meds was $357 and I had to pay a copay because it's outside of base. For $50. I'm looking at the clock and I gotta be out of here by 8:15, 8:20 at the latest. So, once I get in the car and get my stuff, get me together, I'll come back and I'll talk to y'all while I drive to work. I'll explain a little bit more detail about the stealing. Like I was on a road trip yesterday, okay? My show came home. I finished cooking chicken breast, potatoes, and broccoli, and a pasta salad. I went and sat my ass down and did not get back up for the rest of the day and was out like a light. I slept good last night, okay? like really listening to this Rosenberg this morning. Whew, y'all know I gotta come to y'all where I can see y'all, where y'all can see me, okay? However, they were talking about why or how, not even how and why. Basically, you have biracial relationships where there are parents or family members who are not particularly, I guess, supportive of whomever being in the opposite race or a different race or nationality in a relationship. So pretty much if it was a Cuban man can't bring home an American black girl, but he can bring home a black Cuban. And Rosenberg was like, well, aren't Cubans black? Well, that's the only reason I'm using that particular race is just because that was the caller that was on the phone. The discussion was about, is it being racist or is it cultural of the reason why some families aren't supportive of biracial or different races or nationalities mixing in relationships? And they were just saying that a lot of it is cultural. Now, I don't know, y'all. I kind of beg to differ. I can see some of it can be cultural. I can see some of it can be seen as racist. To me, it's racist when, you know, people are saying rude or derogatory things in reference to black people, Mexican people, you know, different nationalities. To me, I find that racist because you specifically call out what it is you don't like, or, oh no, my son or my daughter will never date a white or a black man, okay? Okay, that's cool. But me, personally, I've never dated outside of my race. And it's not something I can sit here and say, like, I'm proud of. It just never happened. I never found myself attracted to a white man when I was growing up. Now, there are some white men, some Caucasian men I find quite attractive now as a grown woman. Oh my God, what is his name? He plays in Hangover. Oh my God, he has dated J-Lo, okay? Woo, that man right there, he fine. And I know y'all know which one I'm talking about. He got icy blue eyes. He always have like a beard. I can't even think of his name right now. His name was right on the tip of my tongue, y'all. But I personally just have never been attracted to a white man in my growing up. Let me see if it's back on.
The Geico Insurance Agency can help you insure your home, apartment, or condo at cost.
So basically, there were black women calling in saying that they only date white men. And Rosenberg was like, well, what are you? And they said that they were black. And he said, well, why? And he was like, you know, well, she was like, mainly, she was from North Carolina. And basically, she's always thought that black men are very disrespectful when it comes to women of color. They don't appreciate their women. They don't value us. It's always a disrespect. And she says, she quote unquote quoted them white chocolate. She was like, they are very in tune with our culture, you know, things such as like hair, things as such as how we celebrate holidays and all of this. And she was like, you know, that's just my preference. I just prefer to date white men. And so Rosenberg asked her, well, have you ever dated a brother? And she basically was like, no, and she never had an intention to. And I don't know. When it comes to me, like I said, I personally have never experienced dating outside of my race. A black man snatched me off the market pretty damn quick, okay? And I love my black men, okay? But I love my particular black man I got, okay? However, if it was Jada or Jasmine, I honestly can say I see no color
when it comes to who they date. Just for the simple fact as to me, why cut yourself off from love? Why say that, you know, you, what if a white man is interested in you or a Hispanic man is interested in you? Shit, don't matter, okay? What if? Would I be closed-minded that as someone that is treating my daughters right, you know, respecting them, understanding who they are, and understanding what type of family that, you know, she has been raised by? I have no qualms with that. I just think that that's probably the biggest thing that's wrong with this world right now, is that we can't get past seeing, I guess, seeing color. I mean, granted, our ancestors have went through a whole lot, and it will never ever be enough to, I guess, forgive America for what they have did to us. However, it's like, if you keep living closed-minded and you don't open yourself and your mind and your heart to accept people for who they are, you're gonna be pretty lonely.
Today's gonna be a good day. Best believe.
Y'all, I am like really feeling the way I did my eye makeup today. A burst of violet. Yes. Yes, y'all, I am ready for spring. Little lunch up so I can, you know, sit outside. It's nice outside, but it's a little too cool. So, y'all, I just had my lunch. And it was good. I sat in the car because I wanted to sit outside on the benches, but that didn't happen due to the fact that, hey, your girl didn't want to deal with bees. No, just coming off a break.
Oh, all right. Nice, nice, nice to be inside.
I know. You too. My gosh. Hold on, hold on. Been dancing all night long. Yes. I had to. Cause that decided to come back out. Y'all know I enjoy my food when I eat. I swear 15 minutes go by fast. Too fast. So, y'all know how it is. After you come back off a lunch break, I didn't even eat anything heavy. But when I tell y'all I got the itis, something about eating and it being warm outside, it just being warm and the heat don't help the situation. Oh, honey. So let me get back out here on this floor, and I got 2.5 hours left till I get off. Oh, Father. So I'll see y'all when I get off. Alright, I'm so happy to be off work. Today was torture with all these spring breakers.
Abundance Nation back. Y'all doing? Y'all see my cousin Tay Tay lately? Cause I ain't seen her ass. Where she at?
Y'all, my cousin Shanaysha talking about she looking for me. I've been right here this whole damn time. She better ask somebody. Okay, so Shanaysha is just so cute. She throwing a little shade because she want to go to Philly with us today. But girl, all you got to do is ask. So, I told her she can go and she is all happy now. So, y'all let me get this face on bleak and I'll see y'all in a bit.
Oh my God, y'all. Tay Tay said I could go with them today. So, let me get cute. Let me get cute because I got to match their flat.
Two rappers and three singers. She got a few athletes on speed dial. I'm trying to get the case dismissed before I see you.